Unisat Wallet has become one of the most popular choices for storing and swapping assets on the BRC-20 network. In this video, I will give you a quick tutorial on how to set up a wallet and use its most popular features. Let's get right into it. For starters, you'll want to head over to unisat.io on a Google Chrome browser. From there, you press download from Chrome Store and install the extension. This is what we'll use to create our wallet. After the extension is installed, you'll be directed to a pop-up window. Here, you'll select Create Wallet and choose a wallet password. This is what you'll use whenever you want to make a transfer, so make sure to pick something you'll remember. After that, you'll be displayed your recovery phrase. You'll need this in case you lose access to your wallet, so note it down carefully. Next, it's time to select your address type. Unless you're really nerdy when it comes to crypto, I would simply leave this the way it is. And there you have it. We've now created our Unisat wallet. From here, we can buy, send, and receive crypto. Pressing receive will give you a QR code that you can scan with your phone, and clicking on the gray address will copy your wallet address to your clipboard so you can paste it in on an exchange when you transfer assets from there. Next up, we have send. This is also pretty straightforward. You simply enter a recipient's address and how much you'd like to transfer to them. Similar to MetaMask wallet, you also get to choose which transaction speed you'd like. The faster the transaction, the higher the fee, obviously. And finally, the Buy tab will take you to MoonPay, which is a third-party platform where you can buy crypto with your debit or credit card. I personally wouldn't recommend this since there are cheaper ways to purchase crypto, like making a regular bank payment to an exchange and then transferring it from there, but it's a nice feature nevertheless. Down at the bottom, we can switch tabs from the Wallet menu to the Discover menu. Here you'll find different NFTs that are currently being inscribed on the BRC20 network. Not much else to do here, it's mainly good for mindless scrolling. The button next to the Discover tab will take you to the App Center, which is where you'll be able to find different NFT marketplaces and likewise that are compatible with Unisat Wallet. I'll quickly go over the native Unisat apps in this video. The first one is Unisat Inscribe. Here you'll be able to upload files that you wish to inscribe on the BRC20 network. In other words, you can create your own NFT and transfer it to your Unisat Wallet with the click of a button. I'll give you a quick example by uploading a random sound file. After I've uploaded the file, I'll be asked to paste in my wallet address and then I can choose how quickly I want the inscription to happen. Once again, the faster, the more expensive. The fee will be calculated and displayed before you make the transaction. After I'm satisfied with what I put in, I simply hit Pay Invoice and from there I can choose if I want to pay with my Unisat wallet or with an external BTC wallet. Once my payment has gone through, the inscription will start right away. Next up, we have the Unisat Marketplace. Here you'll be able to find anything from BRC20 NFTs to whole cryptocurrencies that are available on the BRC20 network. I'll go into the Bitcoin apes to make an example. Whenever you find an asset in the marketplace that you like, you can simply hit buy and choose to pay with your Unisat wallet. Unisat will then make the whole purchase process very easy for you. You'll be displayed the complete price of the asset and it will be automatically transferred to your wallet at the same time as the Bitcoin you're paying with will be automatically deducted. And lastly, we have the settings tab. Here you'll be able to change address type, once again, only for the really dedicated people, and you'll also be able to see which sites you've connected your Unisat wallet to. You can also change the lock screen password that we selected in the beginning. And that's pretty much it for this quick overview of the Unisat wallet. I really hope you found it helpful. If you have any questions or corrections, you are more than welcome to leave me a comment. See you in the next video. Until then, have a good one.